Hi everyone, this is Balázs from RacingBrick. The mighty Liebherr LR 13000 is back. This is my second video with this beast. If you missed the first one with the unboxing, the building presentation and demonstration of the features and the app, then I recommend you watch it as well. As always, you can find the link in the top right corner. Thanks so much for your feedback and suggestions. I will do my best to show you almost everything you wanted to see from this set. I will show some details that weren't so obvious in the first video, a size comparison with different cranes and other Technic sets, then I will do some tests on lifting weights with the stock counterweight configuration to show you the limits, and at the end we will add more weights to both ends of the crane and see what happens. Let's get started! The first thing to mention is an interesting detail. As you can see, this cardboard cover has the length chart for the axles and beams, and the usual beam length check on each page is missing from the manual itself. As for the counterweight pieces, unfortunately they don't seem to have standard LEGO connections. These holes here are too small for studs or pins, but too large for LEGO rods. And no, they aren't magnetic, they just seem to stick together a bit due to their large flat surfaces, but that's about it. I think they are solid plastic, they don't seem to have any metal in them. I don't have the old weight bricks at hand, but they have a completely different form factor and according to Bricklink they are heavier too. A small note on the placement of the hubs. They are not fixed, they just slide on these pins. Unlike others, I don't consider this a problem, it really helps with battery replacement. I can't imagine a scenario where your crane is in a position where the hubs fall off. If that happens, you already have a big problem anyway. Now for the features. You asked what the different winches can do. These two here in the middle with the color code green are responsible for the hook. The red one at the rear end controls the main boom, and the white one at the front end controls the jib. The new spool parts are nothing special, they are just bigger than the old ones. Now for the load sensor. I've shown you how the assembly works on the hub, but let's go through the whole system. The main boom is controlled by this pulley system here. When a load is lifted, the main boom is pulled, and this tricky assembly here at the tip of the derrick boom moves and pulls these links that pull this assembly behind the hub. Because the hub is suspended, it tilts slightly in case like this. There is a maximum tilt angle for the hub that is not the weight limit for the crane, so as I mentioned earlier, the tilt of the whole superstructure is actually calculated in the limits. Now let's look at some size comparisons. Here is a nice collection of LEGO cranes at their maximum height position. You can see how they compare to the new Liebherr crawler crane, I tried to add their model numbers too. Big Red is supposed to have the same height on paper, but there is a clear difference between these two. I still don't understand why the official numbers are lower than reality. The 42042 crawler crane was the last set with a similar structure that was also motorized. However, there was no remote control, but you could control it manually with a gearbox, it could not even turn. The 42082 rough terrain crane has a similar but slightly lower range, the wheels here are not powered, only the crane functions are powered through a gearbox. The lifting capacity was limited by the telescopic boom. I tested it in a video a few years ago and was able to break it with a little more than 1 kg. Since these are old used sets, there might be a few parts missing here and there, some are very dusty inside, so I won't do any motorized comparisons with them this time. Now we are going to look at some big sets that aren't cranes, and these two may help you understand the dimensions of the Liebherr crane, because this thing is just huge. Do you remember how big the Liebherr excavator is? That's just a matter of perspective. Here's another big boy, the bucket wheel excavator, which doesn't stand a chance against this one. You also wanted to know how the car transporter compares in length, that depends on the position of the crane. It can be tall and shorter, but it can also be super long if it needs to be. Now let's see some lifting tests. An interesting value keeps popping up in the comments that I'm not sure where it came from. People are saying that the set is officially rated for 500 grams, but that value isn't on the product page or in the instructions, so I think someone just made it up before the release and it stuck. You also said that I need to use the closest position of the boom for a fair test. Interestingly, there are two settings in the app, one is the closest, the other is the highest. I'm not sure why they call this position the closest, when clearly the highest position is also the closest one. If you know why they would call this position the closest, please let me know in the comments. So, here are a few tests. This is with the empty container, weight is 379 grams. As you see in the closest position, it detects virtually no load and the indicator stays green all the way to the end, while the farthest position cannot be reached as the load touches the ground. Someone asked how low the hook can go. Here the crane is in the uppermost position on top of its box. As you can see, the hook only goes just below the ground level. Now it's time to do the test with 500 grams. Again, in the top position, virtually no load is detected, and when I try to extend the boom, the indicator turns orange but the load touches the ground before it turns red. Let's try it the other way around on an elevated platform. This is the lowest position. As you can see, we are already in red even with 500 grams of load. If I slowly bring it up and back, it will turn orange again. From this, I can conclude that with the stock counterweight, if you want to comply with the safety measures of course, you can't fully extend the boom and jib even with this load. If you ignore the warnings though, it's not a problem. Yes, I know these cranes never do that and only lift loads in their top position, but I'm sure the people who build these sets are not certified crane operators and they will try the full range for sure. Now let's see a magic number, 1213 grams. What is that exactly? Let me show you. That's the weight still going up in orange in the highest position, no warnings. But the moment I move the boom just a little bit, that's what happens. I think that's a critical point because at first glance it seems safe, but it immediately turns into a disaster. Lower safety limits would definitely need it here. Now it's time for some upgrades. I have these four batteries here from my lawnmower, and with a little extra structure they weigh almost 2.8 kilograms. This goes above the original counterweights, let's see how the crane performs. As you can see, with a load of 1 kg, it stays green practically all the way through the range. Doubling up the load to almost 2 kg, it's not a problem to lift it in the closest position, but at some point the limits kick in and it turns red. Still, it's not much of a challenge for the motors. So, time to get serious. In addition to the batteries, let's use this 6 kg kettlebell as an anchor at the rear and exchange the container for something much better. Here's the good old bucket wheel excavator. The weight is about 3.3 kg. Let's see what happens. And the BWE flies! That's a very impressive performance by the crane. Let's see it again. This thing is fully in the air, no doubt. Now what about the Liebherr excavator? That one is a little heavier at 3.9 kg. The strategy is to lower the boom a bit since it's stronger than the hook and then we will try to lift it with that. Well, most of it is in the air but the tracks still touch the ground and the motors stop, so I would say that this is the limit from the point of view of motor and hub power, no extra counterweight will help more. I think it was seriously impressive. Nothing broke, nothing fell apart, the design works very well, even with much heavier loads. Now let's get to the last topic, the price. I'm sure by now everyone knows that the official retail price of the set is 680 euros or $700. You can check it in your local currency by clicking on the link at the top right corner or in the description. That seems like a huge amount for a LEGO set, and I'm sure everyone is focused on the 2883 piece count, and those two numbers don't add up. Let me help you out. The price to piece ratio rarely works these days, and in this case it fails completely, it just doesn't make sense. I'm sure the final price of a LEGO set is determined by many different factors, but to put this set in perspective, I think we would better focus on the weight and the electronic parts included. Let's start with the latter. Two hubs, six motors, how much can that be? I wouldn't check the prices of the individual parts on LEGO.com because they are really exorbitantly high, if they are available at all. I would go with the current Audi instead, it has one hub and three motors for 170 euros. Based on that, I would say that the price for the electronic components there is about 100 euros, so in the case of the Liebherr, let's double that, 200 euros. We are now at 480 euros. Let's look at the weight of this behemoth. Since I don't have a proper scale for this size, my measurements may not be super accurate, but I measured 5.25 kg without batteries. I also calculated the weight of the electronic components. Without them, the net weight of the plastic is 4.53 kg. So we get this amount of plastic for 480 euros. Let's look at two other sets, the Technic and the Ferrari Daytona SP3. The Technic weighs 7.75 kg and costs 680 euros. The Ferrari Daytona weighs only 3.1 kg and costs 450 euros. This means that 1 kg of the non-electronic Liebherr costs around 105 euros. That is about 88 euros for the Technic and a whopping 145 euros for the Ferrari. All in all, you get a lot more LEGO for your money with the Liebherr than with the Ferrari. Of course, this comparison is very simplified. I'm sure people will say that the counterweights, for example, are useless for anything else, but even without the counterweights, The Liebherr is still a better deal from this perspective than the Ferrari. What I'm saying is that while the price seems enormous, it's not that extraordinary if we compare it to some other Technic sets. But, and I must stress this, I would never buy it for the recommended retail price on LEGO.com. Why? If you look around a bit, some retailers are offering the set at almost 30% off even before the release. The lowest offer I could find at the moment was 495 euros, which is an insane discount for a set that is not even available yet. I really don't understand LEGO.com's pricing strategy, and this could be a topic for another video, but if you want to buy this set now, you better find a local retailer with a good price. So, let's sum things up. First, the building experience. If you have already built a Liebherr excavator, then the first part of the build won't show you anything new. If not, then it might be a good experience. I found the second part quite repetitive with all the lattice frames and had to fight with the strings here and there, but in the meantime, it's exciting to see how the structure grows and you realize the real dimensions of the build. The remote control experience is solid. I think the app is pretty good this time around with lots of information and control options. I found two major weaknesses. The superstructure rotation is too fast for my taste. It's unrealistic and perhaps dangerous given the size of the build, and the limits in the app are way too forgiving. The weight detection system is not sensitive enough to warn you in time before disaster happens. You really need to be careful with your load. Then comes the authenticity. That's a tough one because it's a well-built, properly functioning LEGO Technic roller crane, sturdy enough to be tortured with unexpectedly large weights. But meanwhile, it really lacks more counterweights to show you its full potential, and it doesn't look like a Liebherr LR 13000 at all. Yes, there may be similar configurations of this crane, but as you can see in this comparison, the proportions of the various main components relative to each other are still way off. And I know this is just a LEGO set, but we always look for a certain level of accuracy with the builds, and even the Liebherr excavator did a pretty good job in that regard. I think LEGO should have chosen a different, smaller Liebherr crane when they realized they couldn't build this thing much bigger. I don't think it was that important for the general public to get the LR 13000 specifically. And the price. The recommended retail price is very high, but if you put it in relation to other big and expensive Technic sets, it becomes, let's say, at least understandable. But when we see where the actual retail prices will start, it doesn't make much sense, and I recommend everyone to wait a bit and see the price levels after the launch. I wouldn't be surprised to see the set at around 450 euros or dollars before the end of the year. That's still a lot of money for a LEGO set, but if you have enough space at home for such a giant, you can have a unique building and playing experience with this crane. So folks, please let me know your thoughts about this one. What do you think about the set itself, the name on the box, the features, the price? Let's talk about it in the comment section. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe with notifications, as more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye!